It's about opening doors for one another so someone else can enter.
A delegation of distinguished religious leaders from New York visited Utah in mid-June. They are members of New York City's Commission of Religious Leaders.
New York is one of a kind, and to have these strong religious communities in there and then having them figured out how to get tied together, this is a great example of a group that's figured out how to do that.
We have to first think of ourselves as churches without walls and begin the movement to see our community healed.
The interfaith leaders visited Welfare Square in Salt Lake City and learned more about efforts to support those in need by the Church of Jesus Christ.
You know that the church has grown it, raised it, produced it, canned it.
What impressed me most is that you're not just engaged in distribution, but actually production. The culture of missions that you've created that results in volunteers giving their time to a cause, I think it's amazing.
We have not been saved to sit, we've been saved to serve, and that's what we should be doing. And what I saw this morning is an incarnation of the mission of Jesus Christ on a level I've never seen it before.
It's easy to preach it, but people say you have to see a sermon, and we've seen many sermons out here on this visit.
They went to the family history library where they learned more about their families.
I guess what I was most amazed about there was how the extent of the gathering of records has touched so many different countries.
When we discover how we're connected, we treat each other differently. And then we can work together differently.
This is so rich, you know, like, I'm so blown away right now. It's just a little bit overwhelmed.
I don't think there's been one stop that hasn't been absolutely emotional for me. I have been crying on every turn because it is so embodied in God's love.
The New York delegation also met with senior church leaders, including the First Presidency on Temple Square, and then traveled to the campus of Brigham Young University in Provo, Utah, where they joined with an apostle for the Religious Freedom Annual Review.
It is the multitude of good works that religion inspires people of faith to perform on behalf of others.
I remember Elder Buckner coming to my office, and he said, I want you to name for me organizations that do great work in feeding the poor. And you wrote checks that cleared. And so thank you for not distinguishing between the Christian poor and the Muslim poor and the Jewish poor, for seeing all humans as having that same spiritual birth certificate and belonging to one family.
Thank you.